As for our agenda, we certainly will go into the fundamentals of the 510K process 101, as I call it, because there are certain expectations and rules that certainly need to be taken under due consideration, and unconditional compliance must be met in order to ensure success. But we certainly want to understand the differences between traditional, special, and abbreviated submissions. A very important term right now between industry and FDA is SE, also known as substantial equivalence, and how that will be implied as well as interpreted. Then more importantly, who is required to submit the submission or the application, where to submit the 510K, and what to expect with the review and approval process on behalf of the Center for Devices and Radiological Health, or if you're in vitro diagnostics, potentially the Office of In Vitro Diagnostics. Certainly, we want to identify where and when it is and is not required. If you are a device company, we'll certainly briefly go into the exemptions or exclusions to the submission process, and also some general special considerations. And then, more importantly, how to locate a predicate device and go through the content and format of the 510K process to ensure consistency, continuity, and uniformity. One thing that I'm going to underscore here today in our presentation is that good housekeeping is very, very business critical with you when you submit your application to FDA. This is to ensure that there are no documentation red flags or trigger points, as we call it. The 510K process going forward will be under microscopic scrutiny based on preliminary indicators coming in from FDA as well as from industry groups, as stated previously.